Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Jai Shri Javaji. Today we shall continue to start reading the chapters of the book Time Power by Brian Tracy, part 29. The acid test of prospecting, a good measure of how well you are doing in prospecting, determine how far in advance you are booked for sales appointments and presentations. A good salesperson usually has their appointments for the following week, all planned out by Friday of the previous week. If you ask where he or she is going to be the next week, he can tell you within 1 hour where he will be each day from Monday to Friday. Poor salespeople have no idea where they will be in the coming week. They have few appointments and no plans. Every day is a new adventure for them. They don't know how it is going to turn out. As a result, they work less than 90 minutes a day and spend most of their time around the office or having lunch or coffee with their co-workers. From now on, resolve to plan every day the day before, preferably at the end of the day or in the evening. Make out a list of everything that you have to do the following day and organize the list by time and priority before you turn out the lights. Set a goal to structure your day with appointments 30 to 60 minutes apart. The law of forceful efficiency says that if you put tight time constraints on yourself for each appointment, you will cover everything of importance in the sales call within the time allotted. Plan your calls geographically. One of the most important time management techniques for salespeople is to group your calls in a specific geographic area. This enables you to reduce travel time and to increase the number of calls that you can make during the day. Keep reminding yourself that you have nothing to sell but your time. Face to face with prospects and customers, and how you use your time determines your income. Don't make the mistakes of making your first appointment in the north end of your town and your second appointment in the south end and spending half your day driving in between. Many poor salespeople organize their time this way. They are somehow able to convince themselves that they are actually working when they are traveling great distances between appointments. Close the sale. One of the best time management techniques is to close the sale after the presentation so that you do not have to go back over and over. Give the prospect an opportunity to buy at the end of every sales conversation. Ask for the order one way or another. Fully 50% of all sales calls end without the salesperson asking for the order once. One of the very worst uses of time is for you to go through the laborious process of prospecting, getting appointments, making presentation, answering objections, and then not losing the sale. For you to lose the sale because you cannot or will not ask a closing question wipes out all of the time you have invested up to now. Study and become proficient with a variety of closing techniques or decision-making questions. A closing technique can be defined as a question that gets the prospect to commit to an action of some kind or to comment one way or another on your product. For example, you can ask simple questions that tell you how well you are doing, which give you feedback from the prospect. Ask questions such as following. Does this make sense to you far? Second one. Do you have any questions or concerns that I have not covered? Third one. Do you like what I am showing you so far? Fourth one. Is this the sort of thing you are looking for? Invite him to buy. If it appears that the prospect likes what you have shown him, interested in what you are selling, you can use the invitational clause and ask, well, if you like it, why don't you give it a try? You can use the directive clause which says, well, then if you have no further questions, next step is, and you go on and explain the plan of action and wrap up the sale. It is amazing how much time you can save in your sales career if you just muster up the courage to invite people to make a decision on your offering. In follow-up interviews with prospects, it is amazing how many of them have said that they would have bought if the salesperson had just asked them or invited them to buy. It is sad that so many sales are lost every single day because the salesperson does not ask for the order. Developing a habit of asking for the order in a polite, courteous, and carefully pre-planned way is a tremendous technique for improving your efficiency and productivity. Eliminating the time wasters in selling. There are several time wasters in selling. Based on the interviews with thousands of salespeople and sales managers, here are the 10 major reasons why people waste their time and fail to realize their full potential sales and income. First one, procrastination. Procrastination is the thief of time. It is usually accompanied by delaying tactics or finding all kinds of excuses for not getting out and getting going. Usually, procrastination is caused by a deep fear of rejection or fear of failure. This is often called reluctance. This kind of fear of rejection and disapproval, which leads to procrastination and delay, can only be overcome by confronting it every day until it goes away. The most remarkable thing about your fears is that if you face them squarely, they diminish. But if you back away from them or avoid the situation that you fear, your fears grow until they paralyze all productive action. When I started selling, I was terrified of cold calling and prospecting. But then I learned something that changed my career. I learned that rejection is not personal. If a person says that they are not interested in what you are selling, it is not aimed at you personally. It's merely an automatic response to a commercial offer in a competitive society. The person does not know you well enough to reject you personally. Rejection is not personal. Once I learned that, I began calling on people both door-to-door and office-to-office and by telephone. All my fears of rejection disappeared. Eventually, I reached a point where the negative reaction to my sales activities had no effect on me at all. This must be your goal as well. Second one, incompletion of the sale. Incomplete sales that require callbacks are a major time waster. This usually occurs when the salesperson doesn't have everything he needs to make the sale. Sometimes because of poor preparation, salespeople do not have the proper price list, the proper brochures, the correct inventory figures, or the necessary information to conclude the sale. Third one, poor preparation. Poor preparation is usually visible when there are obvious inaccuracies and deficiencies in the presentation. Proper presentation prior to sales call requires that you learn as much about the prospect as possible before you meet with him or her. There is nothing quite so insulting to a prospect when a salesperson tries to sell them something without knowing anything about him. Fourth one, ignorance. A salesperson usually demonstrates his or her ignorance with a lack of product knowledge. The salesperson has obviously not taken the time to study the sales literature to thoroughly understand the product or service that he or she is trying to sell. When the customer has questions about the product or service, the salesperson stumbles or bluffs or tries to make up an answer. This not only undermines the credibility of the salesperson and the company, but it shakes the confidence of the salesperson as well. Know what you are selling. Some years ago, my wife and I went out looking for an expensive home in San Diego. We contacted several realtors to view home for sale. Having been a real estate agent and broker at one time, I know a lot about buying and selling real estate. As we would drive up to a house that was for sale for several hundred thousand dollars, I would ask the agent a series of questions about the house. I was always amazed to find out that very few of the realtors had even taken the time to read the MLS sheet to get the details of the house. Many of them had never been to the open houses on the homes they were showing for sale. They were attempting to sell a product where they would be earning several thousand dollars in commission, and they often had no idea of size of house or any of the amenities. They had not earned the right to offer the product for sale because they had not taken the time to fully understand the product in the first place. Fifth one, unconfirmed appointments. Unconfirmed appointments lead to the situation where the salesperson arrives for an appointment that was made by phone and finds that the prospect is gone. The salesperson has now wasted the time he spent in prospecting, the time of preparation, and the time of travel. Why does this happen so often? The main reason is because of the fear of rejection. The salesperson is reluctant to phone and confirm the appointment for fear that the prospect will cancel it. Here is a very simple method that has been effective for me and many other salespeople over the years. You call the office of the prospect before you leave. You ask the receptionist if the prospect is in. If the receptionist says yes, then you say, "Thank you very much. Please tell him that this is Brain Tracy calling and that I will be there for my appointment on schedule." You then hang up the phone. In this way, you remind the prospect that you are coming, and you put the prospect under a sense of obligation to see you when you arrive. You stop wasting your time by going out to unconfirmed appointments. Sixth one, poor planning of calls geographically. One of the biggest time wasters in selling is traveling all over your sales territory, spending most of your time in traffic rather than face to face with people who can and will buy within a reasonable period of time. One simple way to cluster your calls geographically is to divide your territory into four parts. Discipline yourself to work in one quadrant of your territory each day or half day. If you call to make an appointment, tell the prospect that you will be visiting customer in his area at a specific time of this week. Would he be available to see you at that time? It is interesting to note that more structured and scheduled your time usage is as a salesperson, the more you are respected by your prospects and customers. The more that they feel that you have a tight schedule, the more they will ease the schedule to accommodate meeting with you. Needless perfectionism. Perfectionism occurs when you insist that everything be perfectly in order before you go out and sell. It is another form of indecisiveness, and it closely tied up with call reluctance. It is caused by fear of rejection and fear of failure. 8th one, distraction or mind wandering. These are subtle time wasters, but there are far too common. The result in not paying attention is sales presentation. You do not heed the prospect fully, or you do not read between the lines to understand what the prospect is really saying. Many salespeople are guilty of this. They simply do not pay sufficient attention because they are preoccupied with their own thoughts. Unfortunately, this happens very quickly and soon loses all interest in doing business with you. The way that you overcome the tendency to mind wander is to discipline yourself to face the prospect directly. Lean forward and watch him intently while he speaks. Imagine that your eyes are sun lamps and you want to give his face a tan. This approach will keep you focused more intensely on the prospect and snap you out of the tendency towards distraction. 9th one, fatigue and overwork. These are the real killers in every area of work, and especially in selling. It is estimated that more than 50% of salespeople today are working in a state of fog. They are going to bed too late and not getting enough sleep. As a result, they go through the day night lacking the ability to fully concentrate on their work. My rule is this: if you are going to sell 5 days of the week, you must go to bed early 5 days per week. Selling is a very draining and demanding profession. It requires a tremendous amount of physical and emotional energy to be very effective at sales. You cannot afford to stay up late at night watching television or socializing if you are going to be sharp and alert the next day. You can break the tendency to sleep too little and work too hard by disciplining yourself to go to bed by 10 o'clock each night. Turn off the television and resolve it lots of rest. This will translate into more and better sales, higher income, and generate the money you need to take all the vacations you want. 10th one, lack of ambition or desire. There are many people who are just going through the motions work. This is usually the result of having too few goals or having no goals at all. Sometimes people lack ambition or desire because they are selling the wrong product. They are trying to sell something that they don't like or believe in. Sometimes lack of ambition or desire to succeed in sales is caused by believing in your boss or not believing in the company or not getting along well with your co-workers. Whatever the reason, if you are not positive and enthusiastic about your product or services, this could be an indication that you should be doing something else. If you don't like the people you are selling to, you are probably in the wrong business. You cannot for very long force yourself to sell something that is wrong for you. It will simply make you tired and depressed, and you will never be successful at it. Use your time well. Here are some valuable ideas you can use to help increase your sales. First one, get to bed early. Early to bed, early to rise is the key to sales success. Get up and get going by 6 a.m. Get lots of sleep. Sometimes the very best use of your time is to go to bed early and get a solid 9 or 10 or even 12 hours of sleep so that you can bright-eyed and cheerful the next morning. It is very hard to be full of energy, excitement, enthusiasm about your product or service when you are tired from not getting enough sleep. Second one, start your day right. Read 30 to 60 minutes in sales or motivation to start your day. This is one of the most important habits you will ever develop. Many salespeople have told me that this technique of getting up each morning and reading 30 to 60 minutes has changed the whole direction of their career. If you spend 30 to 60 minutes reading a book on sales each morning over the course of a week, you'll probably read one whole book. If you read one book per week for the next year and you don't even read one on weekends or holidays, you will read 50 books on sales over the next 12 months. If you keep this up over the next 10 years, you will read 500 books in a world where the average salesperson never reads a book on sales in his or her life. Do you think that if you read 500 books over the next 10 years, that it would affect your income? The fact is that you would probably become one of the best informed, best skilled and highest paid salespeople in America simply by reducing 30 to 60 minutes on sales each morning. Each day you can go out and apply something that you learned morning. You never stop learning and growing. Third one, start work early. Schedule your first appointment early. Get up, get out, and get going. Try to set your first appointment for 8 a.m. or even 7:30 a.m. Often prospects who do not have time to see you in the daytime can meet with you at odd hours. Sometimes they work early or work late or work both. If you offer to meet them for breakfast or meet them in their office at 7:30 a.m., they can often fit you in. Okay, all. Let's end up for today. We shall continue to start reading the chapters of the book, Time Power. Thank you for continuously listening to our recordings. Have a great day.